Hello everyone, I am Ridula Chaturvedi with the Python programming. Learning outcomes: after studying this topic, students will be able to understand the basic terms and facts. No concept and usage of selection and iteration statement. Analyze the problem, decide and evaluate conditions. Now, what is Python? Python is a powerful general-purpose programming language. It is used in web development, data science, creating software, prototypes, and so on. Fortunately for beginners, Python has simple, easy-to-use syntax. This makes Python an excellent language to learn to program for beginners. Python keywords. Keywords are reversed words in Python. We cannot use a keyword as a variable name, function name, or any other identifier. They are used to define the syntax and structure of the Python language. In Python, keywords are case sensitive. There are 33 keywords in Python 3.7. This number can vary slightly over the course of time. All the keywords except true, false, and none are in lowercase and they must be written as they are. Now the number data type in Python. Python supports integer, floating point numbers, that is the decimal number, complex number. They are defined as int, float, and complex classes in Python. Integers and floating points are separated by presence or absence of decimal point. For instance, 5 is an integer, whereas 5.0 is a floating point number. Complex numbers are written in the form of x plus yj, where x is the real part and y is the imaginary part. We can use the type function to know which class a variable or a value belongs to, and is instance function to check if it belongs to a particular class. While integers can be any length, a floating point number is accurate only up to 15 decimal places. Conditional and iterative statements. Programs are written for solution to the real world problems. A language should have the ability to control the flow of execution so that at different intervals, different statements can be executed. Structured programming is a paradigm aim at controlling the flow of execution of statements in a program by using control structures. A language which supports the control structure is called the structured programming language. So, type of control structures: sequence, selection, iteration or looping, branching or jumping statements. Sequence. Sequence is the default control structure. Instructions are executed one after another, like statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, and so on. This is the flowchart of the statement. Sequence program. So, sequence is default control structure. Instructions are executed one after another. This program adds two numbers. So, how we add the numbers? So, we define sum of two numbers. Then num1 is 1.5, num2 6.5, sum is equal to float num1 plus float num2, print the sum is equal to sum. So sum of two numbers. We can easily find the sum of two numbers. Selection. A selection statement causes the program control to be transferred to a specific flow based upon whether a certain condition is true or not. Conditional construct, also known as if statement, provide a way to execute a chosen block of code based on the runtime evaluation of one or more Boolean expressions. In Python, the most general form of a conditional is written as follows. If, first condition, first body, else if, second condition, second body, else if, third condition, third body, and else fourth body. Here we should know that the colon is must. Conditional construct if else statement. This is the flowchart. condition, false, then statement 1, statement 2, and condition true, so statement 1, statement 2. That is the statement 2 is main body and statement 1 else body. Conditional constraint if else statement. Each condition has a Boolean expression and each body contains one or more commands that are to be executed conditionally. If the first condition succeeds, the first body will be executed. No other conditions or bodies are evaluated in that case. If the first condition fails, means that is false, then the process continues in similar manner with the evaluation of the second condition, and the execution of this overall construct will cause precisely one of the bodies to be executed. There may be any number of else clauses. Example, here is an example of if statement. If example A is equal to 5, if A is less than 10, 5 is less than 10. Statement after if statement. Else is missing, it is an optional statement. Now the reflection spot. Is Python case sensitive when dealing with identifiers? A, yes. B, no. C, machine dependent. D, none of the mentioned. So answer is yes. Python is case sensitive. Case is always significant here. Second, what is the maximum possible length of an identifier? 31 character, 63 character, 79 character, or none of these? So our answer is none of these, because identifiers can be of any length. Next question, the all keywords in Python are in. First, lowercase, uppercase, capitalized, and none of the mentioned. Our answer is none of this, because true, false, and none are capitalized while the others are in lowercase. Fourth question, how many keywords are there in Python 3.7? 33, 43, 53, or none of the above? Our answer is 33. There are 33 keywords in Python 3.7. Last but not the least question is, while writing if else statement, what is must? Semicolon, colon, full stop, none of the above. So our answer is colon. Colon is must while writing the if else statement. Thank you very much.